Hello guys, and we're here today with another very interesting deck profile. We're here today with some Monarchs. Yes, some Monarchs. And this is a very great deck, this format, because it's very cheap. I mean, no extra deck makes it even cheaper, and the fact that this deck can be gotten pretty easily in a structure deck with just some minor changes. I don't think Karaz is in there, and there's some extra cards that you don't need. But I mean, like, you could get the important cards for probably $5-$6, maybe $7 at the most in a Monarch. Just by buying them individually. So let's just go right in to the deck profile, running 3 Erebus, 3 Aesir, and then 2 Karaz. That is it for all of our Monarch monsters. We don't want to run a lot of monsters in the spell because I'm running Carter Demise, and I feel Carter Demise is really good for getting to these Monarchs and just seeing more Monarch spell and trap cards, because this deck doesn't need a spell summon, doesn't spell summon out a lot, so you can easily just go for a Carter Demise play. I mean, if you have Yiddos and Domain, Carter Demise is going to be very, very strong. I mean, drawing into a Monarch, and you, at that point, you're really good and set to go. So, Erebus will shuffle a card from your opponent's hand field or graveyard into the deck, and Aesir will summon out a monarch monster from your deck, and then Karaz will target 2 cards on the field, destroy them, and then the owners of those cards will draw 2 cards. So definitely very strong plays. Aesir can summon out Karaz, and then Karaz effect can trigger, and then you can pop him and maybe your opponent's monster or whatever. Definitely very great. And for our small, I don't want to call them vassals because these guys aren't vassals and we're not running any vassals, but pretty much 3 Yiddos and 3 Aedir. And then technically we're running 4 Aedir because we have the 1 Rota. Very strong, very great. Just being able to see, even if you're just seeing Yiddos, as long as you have Domain or Prime Monarch, you're pretty strong and pretty set. Seeing Aedir is great because now you can even do more combos because it will add back Banished Pantheism. So he's definitely very useful to see and very powerful, just getting out another tribute. And if you're having trouble seeing these monsters, you can always put in another 1-for-1 for Aedir. And if you're having trouble getting to your Monarch monsters, then I suggest putting in something like a Cecilos, Mega Monarch Cecilos, and maybe Kaius, Mega Kaius or something like that. And that is it for the monsters. Again, not a lot because of Card of Demise. Now onto the spell and trap cards. For the generic ones, we have the 2 Card of Demise, the Rota, the Upstart, and then the Warning. Warning's pretty decent in this deck. I mean, it's great for the mirror match. And we do have other forms of stun. Monarch Stormforth, if you have Aether in hand, very powerful play. And Monarch Stormforth is what makes this deck so strong. But I'll talk to you about Monarch Stormforth later. For the other cards, Upstart and Rota, just more consistency. And Card of Demise, again, this deck doesn't do a lot of special summoning, so I see no reason why not, because if you draw into a Monarch monster, and then Monarch spell and trap cards like a Monarch Stormforth, or a Domain, or a Return, or March, it's just very strong. I mean, you won't be able to get off Aedir's effect, and if you have to ditch an Aedir, it's not that bad, because he still gets to add you something to your hand. But I mean, just drawing into one of these guys, and if it's been a turn where you haven't done any special, where you don't need to do any special summon, it's very great. Like, you're not supposed to use this when you open. You're supposed to use this like turn 3 maybe. Well, not turn 3, that would be like your second turn, assuming you're going first. Your third turn is when you could probably start playing Card of Demise, because at that point, you've seen a couple of your Eidos, or maybe you've seen Prime Monarch. Because I mean, if you get Prime Monarch in your graveyard and you summon it out during your opponent's end phase, and it's there when you start your turn, and you haven't done any spell summon that turn, and you have Domain, or you use Card of Demise to get Domain, it's very, very strong. Or maybe you don't get Domain, but you draw into Eidos, this is also just as strong. So that is it for the generic stuff. For the Monarch spell trap cards, 3 Pantheism, of course, for draw power, 3 Tenacity, just for more searching. Emperor Freezing Air allows you to get rid of set cards, including monsters that are face down. But most of the time, you're going to be using this for back row. You can banish it from your graveyard to pop an opponent's back row, so it's a great card to ditch with with Erebus and Aesir, ditching like a Pantheism, Prime Monarch, and now Emperor's Freezing Air. And I always like to ditch Tenacity if I already have like a Pantheism in my graveyard or something. So there's a lot more targets for you to dump with these guys, and then Monarch Stormforce is what makes this so great, because honestly this deck would probably have a lot of trouble against Cosmos, but the fact that you can get around the whole floating thing, can't be targeted just with this one card, they won't float, the machines won't summon out another machine, So it's really strong and it gets rid of everything. And just so having this card is really great against Cosmos, really great against the Mio Magicas. Now you can, if they have Erebus and you have AZ, you can just activate this and drop him. You don't need any of those. You don't need a Prime Monarch. You don't need a Domain. So Mono Stormforth is what makes this deck. It's always a card I try to put back in with Prime Monarch, because I like to have two Prime Monarchs on my side of the field as spells, and then one on in the monster zone. That's how I like to do it. Sometimes it doesn't end up that way, but I mean, if I can get it to be that way, that's how I like it. And then on March, I like March because it's kind of annoying. Just having this card, and now your opponent has to deal with one, not being able to special summon from the extra deck, because this is what hurts them. Draco Palace and Burning Abyss, and then it can also hurt Cleaforts as well if you're going up against that deck. But this will hurt the Cosmos, because now they can't use Dark Destroyer, they have to use Cosmojo, and they can't use, well, they can still use Sliprider, and they can use Sliprider to pop, but I mean, if they don't have access to Sliprider right away, this card is going to really slow them down, and it's really going to protect your monsters. And it's going to be like, alright, he's attacking into my Farm Girl, and I have Dark Destroyer in my hand, and he has Domain. If I banish Farm Girl and summon out him, all I will get will be to float. I won't be able to pop anything. Which honestly wouldn't be too bad. I mean, they probably would target Dark Destroyer and then summon out Sliprider and pop March. That would be the smart thing to do, but sometimes they don't. Or maybe if they have Cosmo Town, they'll summon out, I can't remember, it's Landwalker, is that what it is? It's supposed to be the AT-AT. And then they'll destroy Cosmo Town. But I mean, definitely very useful. Protects your monsters. And just overall very nicely. Return of Monarch, don't get striked. Pretty much that's what this card is for, really, is you can't get striked. You can't get, Solemn Strike has nothing to do against you, unless of course they hit Idea or Eidos. But if you summon out a Monarch monster, it's either they're warning it or its effect's gonna go through, because this is Chainlink 2, these guys are gonna be Chainlink 1. So definitely very strong, and the search is really nice. I mean, summon out Erebus, getting rid of a card and then getting Aesir. If you can get yourself a Monarch Stormforth, that's even better. And then Domain reduces their level by 2, so they require one less tribute, except for this guy. I don't think you can do it to this guy. Not sure. Once per turn, reduce the level 1. Okay, so here's what I've seen people do. If they have two Domains in their hand, what they do is they'll use one Domain on Aesir, and then they'll activate this, and then use it on the same Aesir, and then it reduces it to 4, and then they can just drop it. It has to have 2800 attack. You can't do it with this guy. You can't reduce Karaz level. You can reduce this guy. But he wasn't tribute summoned, so I don't think it gets affected. Yes, he won't get his effect. Domain won't become a control card, but hey, if you have no tributes, and all you have are two Domains, and an Aesir, you can still summon out the Aesir and have a 28 beater. So that's something. And so just really pretty much control against the decks that use a lot of Xyz summons or a lot of Synchro summons. That's what this is for. And then Prime Monarch, just more cycling. Again, you want to have two on your side of the field and one in your grave. Just being able to summon them on out as a monster that you can just use for tribute fodder, or just being able to return stuff to your extra deck. I mean, it's honestly not to your extra deck, to your deck. It makes it so you can't deck out, which is pretty nice, because this deck can go pretty fast. Like, if you're going on to your like fourth or fifth turn, you might be running out of cards if you've opened up decently. And so having this guy just putting in two more and then drawing two cards during your turn, during your opponent's turn, and then during your turn again, oh my god, it's just so strong. And of course, you're putting in cards like Monarch Stormforth and cards like Domain, so those cards, so you can... So you're putting in the cards that really hurt your opponent. You're putting back in March. So, because a lot of these cards you will use early on. Like, if you have a return and you don't have a Monarch and you have Pantheism, you're going to use the Pantheism in the return, especially if you have maybe like 10 Antony or Monarch Stormforth and your opponent has a monster. You don't, or like Prime Monarch. I don't like to ditch Prime Monarch right away either. So this guy, you will have to use your returns and your March for Pantheism. And that is it for the Monarch stuff. Again, this is a very cheap deck, a very powerful deck. Being able to get rid of practically anything with Monarch Stormforth, being able to get rid of cards pretty easily with Karaz, being able to summon out strong monsters, being able to control your opponent, how your opponent and where your opponent's spell summons from, is also definitely very useful. So whether or not this is the best deck this format, That depends. That I can't say. Hope you guys enjoyed the deck. Well, don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. See you guys later.